He's dug in. Help me.
Oh, hey, relax, relax.
How much time do we have?
We don't. Then the time is now.
The other guy.
What were they talking about?
Well, they didn't hear much, but it sounded like they were talking about a woman. Somebody Barlow.
The portrait in your room depicts you alongside Lord Thomas Hamilton, the Lord Proprietor of these Bahama Islands. You see, I've had extensive dealings with the Earl over the years, and so I'd long heard of the tragedy that befell his eldest son, where Thomas's wife had begun a torrid affair with her husband's closest friend. I can only assume that your exile in this place has been less than ideal.
Oh, fucking shit.
Miss Guthrie should have just had you killed. Now, are you going to give me back me whore?
Jeez! On me shoe! Oh, fuck. Listen to me!
Bastard's finally bringing in the first of the guns.
Are they?
Took him long enough. Mr. Guthrie told me I was to see those guns off with my own eyes.
I understand.
What is happening?
The Andromache. It can't be. Captain Bryson hasn't had time to unload.
He didn't. She's riding low. Those guns are still on board.
What are we going to do?
Get them back.
Okay, well, man, I just felt really bad for Billy in this episode because he really just wants to do the right thing. He's a great leader. And I mean, he was, for the most part, right to kind of question that other guy's accusations. I'm liking that Silver is starting to become really cool with Flint and kind of show him, like, look, I am here all for myself, but I am down for this journey, so can't wait to see where that friendship goes, because it's gonna grow. I already know. I can see it. Let's just hope Silver stays on everybody's good side. Poor Vane, he's in a shitty hole, but that last scene kind of made it seem like he was gonna go after Eleanor. And if he's mad enough, I could definitely see something happening. Thanks so much for watching, guys. I will see you in the next one.